Hey guys, so welcome back to the Minish Cap. We just got done learning the sword technique from Swiftblade. So we're ready to go into Mount Crenel. But first thing I gotta do is I gotta grab some bombs, because there's some places that we need to bomb later. I went ahead and looked ahead to see where I would need bombs, and obviously we need more than the bombs that I had. So I just went quick and bought 10 bombs. Right now, well, she wants to fuse a kinstone, so let's check that out. Says there's a rupee. Do you want to fuse kinstones? Well, okay, let's see. And I just happen to have the one kinstone that fits. So maybe something good will happen. I just watched, 900 Red Yoshi's video. He's a little farther than I am. You know, but then again, he was playing sooner than I was, so he was farther before I started mine. But I think in between his Majora's Mask videos, he's going to do Minish Cap, and right now I'm focusing only on Minish Cap and Shiny Gold, so I'll probably end up farther ahead than he will. But anyway, so we have this new spinning sword technique, which is new to us. We've never used this before. So we're going to head over to the west, northwest side and talk to the guard. And we're going to almost kill him. He says, yeah, that's the one. But there are monsters out there, kid. You just make sure you're careful. Make sure we're careful. Well, we will. And we run into Trilby Highlands. Now that fox with the knife, he's like a thief. So be careful, because he'll steal your stuff. And this we can't go to yet because, or can't go west yet because we don't have the new sword with the elements that'll make us be able to lift up that rock. But we'll remember this here for when we come back. So bomb this wall and come in and equip your shield and get this Deku Scrub to shoot a Deku Nut at you so that you can repel it back. Anyway, he gets dazed and says that you got him. And to make it up to you, he's going to sell the most deluxe of all bottles for 20 rupees. So what do you say, huh? Well, we'll need a bottle later on eventually, so why not buy it now? So we got an empty bottle. And he says, thanks a lot. So he's all happy that he got 20 rupees for an empty bottle, which I wouldn't be happy with. I'd have tried to sell it for more. You know. So just head north now. Just going to see what's over on this side of the bridge quick, and I don't think there's anything up here. You know, a couple bushes, but that's about it. You know, just use our rotating sword technique on these bushes. So here's North Hyrule Field. And we can't get up there yet because we don't have the item that lets us get up there. And we can't swim yet. So the only way we can go is more west. We're not west from here. We gotta go down across the bridge and then go more west. I'm just seeing what was down there quick, and there's not a whole lot down there. And you can't come up here either, so just keep going west. And now we're at Mount Crenel base. And would you look at it or not, there's another bombable wall. Boom. So we bomb the wall. And there's another Deku Scrub, so we got equipped our shield again. And he says, we got him. So he says, make it up to you by telling you something good. There's a friend in the cave in the south of Trilby Highlands with a handy tool. If you want to climb Mount Crenel, I suggest you buy it from him. Well, he's just telling us about the bottle we already have. So because he's giving us useless, crappy information, we're going to chop down all of his bushes. There you go. Anyway. So what you have to do with the bottle is you have to come over to the shoreline. Don't fall in, but come over to the shoreline, and when you use it, you'll swipe in some water. So now we have water equipped in. And you need that regular water to water this plant that's right here, this seed. And then That growing sound kind of sounded like the sound Mario makes when he gets a mushroom. Anyway, just grab that 20 rupees quick, and that kind of pretty much pays for the bottle that we would have needed. So if you didn't have any rupees, you could have grabbed that quick. That would have allowed you to get pretty much your bottle right away, or in our case, a refund for the bottle that we bought. Danger, no climbing. Well, we can't climb the wall anyway. So just taking care of some of these spiders, I'm going to re-equip my gust jar, because this white, spidery-looking webby things, well, it gives you damage, but you can also get rid of it with your gust jar. So, you know, as such. So you can see there that we just, you know, quickly got rid of some of the spider web. Yeah. And you'll see a lot of it up here in this Crenel Mountain. It's pretty popular, you know. Along with all these little, like, mini gomas. You know. So here's a suspicious-looking wall. Maybe we should, bomb it? I don't know. Are we gonna bomb that wall? No, we're gonna ignore it. What a retard. Alright, so I just have this impulse to clean up all this, spider gust. So you come over this way, and there's a little fashion door, and there's a Deku in here. So I'll repeat your process for kicking Dekus. He says, oh, you got me. I'll make it up to you by selling you bombs. 10 of them for 30 rupees. What do you say? Well, we don't need bombs right now. We already have bombs. So we don't need bombs, but you will need bombs later. So if you don't have bombs, you'll need bombs. Voila. Bombs. Okay, so bomb the not-so-suspicious-looking hole, and kill these bats, and then grab onto the mushroom to fling yourself across. Ha-cha! Okay, now these guys you really don't have to worry about, but I spend way too much time defeating them. I mean, I really could have just, like, went right past them and not even worried about trying to hurt them. But Elzo pops up and pretty much tells me what I already knew. You take off the masks on them, they're harmless. Well, they're not harmless, they can hurt you, but they do less damage and you can hurt them. So, you know. So, trying to think. Well, I'm recording this after the recording for parts 9 and 10, so I don't know. I'm going to a Brewer game tomorrow. Today is June 10th, but this won't be up for a while, so, you know. But tomorrow's a Brewer game. I'm volunteering, so I don't really get to watch the game, but I get to make money, so that's all good. What else? Man, I don't know. Suppose, I'm probably gonna finish up Shiny Gold this week, too. This coming up week, this Monday. I'm just gonna record all of it and get it all done so that I can leave it. Other things. Kirby's Adventure, or Kirby's Nightmare in Dreamland. I'm gonna start the Meta Knight sub-game and do that as my, second half of the Kirby LP. So that'll go together. Trying to think what else. I don't know, I'm trying to decide on new LPs I can do. You know, I haven't like really decided on anything yet. But I did download a lot of games. There's a game Kirby game my friend told me about called Kirby and the Amazing Mirror. And I think I'm gonna LP that one because that sounds like fun. So I'll definitely be doing that one. So that's it. That'll be after I get done with the Meta Knight side of the Kirby game I'm playing now. Anyway, So this rock is another Minish portal, as Elzo explains. Anyway, right there I was trying to roll, and I couldn't roll. I was too close to the thing, so it changed me back. So there's a vine over here that you can only access as a Minish. And it's just got some bugs in it. So, you know, I wish I had the rocks cape to jump over that. That'd be nice. Jump over that and jump over these spikes. Because, man, are they not pretty. Anyway, so we're going to end on this note with a kin piece, so see you guys next time.